In this video, I'm going to show you two super cool tactics to find thousands of guest blogging opportunities and an extremely effective technique to find low competition keywords using Content Explorer. Plus, I'll show you one bonus tip on finding highly relevant influencers in your niche. Stay tuned. Hey everyone, it's Sam O here with Ahrefs. First things first, we need to talk about Content Explorer. What is Content Explorer anyway? Content Explorer is one tool within Ahrefs' SEO toolset. It's basically a mini search engine that's extremely helpful for SEOs and marketers. Right now, our content index is at about 870 million pages, and we're constantly updating these metrics with fresh data. Plus, we find about 5 million new pages each day, so it's just constantly growing. At this point, I'm going to stop flexing our big data muscles and let's just jump right into these cool SEO tactics. The first hack is a way to find thousands of guest blogging sites with Content Explorer. So first, you go to the Content Explorer tool and then you'll type in a keyword phrase that's closely related to your industry. So for example, I might type in something like video marketing as a phrase match. And here you can see that there are about 77,000 highly relevant results. You can see that there are multiple articles from the same sites. But all we need right now is a list of unique websites to guest post for. So you can use this filter right here, one article per domain, which is going to give us only the unique domains that match our search query. Now we're down to about 19,000 results. Next, you're going to want to set one more filter, and that's the highlight unlinked domains filter. If you click here, then you can enter in your domain. So I'll just type in my own personal domain, moneyjournal.com, and click highlight. Content Explorer will then highlight only the domains that have never linked to you. So in general, earning backlinks from websites that have never linked to yours, it's going to bring you more value than a second, third, or even fourth link from previously linking domains. So basically, the highlight unlinked domains filter, it's going to save you a ton of time from pitching websites that you already have links from and that you might not actually know about. So in this case, I probably wouldn't pitch Buffer, Entrepreneur, Contently, Top Rank Blog, and a few others. Finally, you can hit the export button to get all of these results in a spreadsheet. Just make sure that this checkbox here is selected to only export the unlinked websites and click the Start Export button. From here, you can start pitching the different websites that are blogging about your topic. Now, if you've never posted a single guest post before, you might want to try pitching websites that aren't as high profile so that you can get some experience, refine your pitch, and find what works for you. You can do that by setting the domain rating filter to something with a maximum DR of around 30. And a lot of these sites are, they're more likely to accept your pitch since they probably don't have hundreds of requests coming in each day, like a lot of the bigger sites that you might want to write for. All right, so another cool way to find guest posting opportunities is to stalk the people you're constantly seeing popping up on other blogs. And I'm using air quotes here on stalk because I don't literally mean to stalk them in that sense. So the way that you do that in Content Explorer is by using the search operator, author, colon, and then the name of the blogger. So I'll use Christy Hines as an example, since I know that she's written about topics like social media marketing and video marketing. And there are about 250 results here. From here, you can use the same filters as I did in the previous example. So I'll set it to the one article per domain, and then use the highlight unlinked domains feature with my domain. And finally, I'll click highlight. You can then export it, making sure that this checkbox is checked, and we are done. This works particularly well if you are a solopreneur or if you have a small team of content creators. Using the author search operator, it's a really good trick to use because it's basically proof of results, right? The people you're searching for here are likely guest authors. It's not like they own every blog that they write on. So even if they don't have a Write For Us page, they're clearly accepting guest blogging articles. Pretty cool, right? All right, so let's move on to a really unconventional way to come up with new content ideas. And this keyword research tip that I'm about to show you is a super cool way to find extremely low competition topics with high traffic potential. And you're gonna love this because it's a data-driven approach with a little proof of concept. Okay, so here's how it's done. So again, search for a pretty generic keyword related to your industry. So I'll use gardening as an example. And since we know that quality backlinks help you rank in Google and that the overall strength of a website's backlink profile can help your pages rank too, we can set two filters to find low competition keywords. The first filter that we're going to set is the referring domains, and we'll set it to only find results with a maximum of 0 referring domains, so no linking websites at all. Then we'll set the organic traffic filter to have a minimum of 1,000 search visitors per month. Now, when you try this, you might have to play around with the numbers a little bit, but since gardening is a pretty big topic and there's nearly 600,000 results here in the Content Explorer results, you know, I'd say that it's a pretty good number here. After we set the final filter, you'll see that there are over 100 pages that have 0 referring domains, and they get over 1,000 search visitors per month, like this one. This one here, 171 inspirational gardening quotes and sayings. Content Explorer shows that they get 1,400 organic search visitors each month from this post alone. And if I click on the details button and then the organic keywords, you can see the keywords and SERP positions that this page is ranking for. So you'll see that they rank for garden quotes, which has a search volume of 4,500, and they're currently in position 5. Then there's gardening quotes, which has 2,700 searches per month, and currently in position 6, and so on and so forth. You get the point, right? Now, if you run a gardening blog, then this might be a good topic to cover, and it probably wouldn't take too many links or any at all to outrank these pages. And to put the cherry on the top, you'll see that this one has a pretty low to medium domain rating of 44. And if you keep going through this list, there are a ton of really low competition keywords you can start creating content around. Like this one here. This one ranks for succulent care. I'm not sure if I said that right, but it has 9,300 searches per month and ranks in position 5 right now. Now, when Tim showed me this hack, I knew that I had to use it, and I've gotten some pretty insane results, like I've ranked on page 1 in Google in 3 days from publishing the article, and I can't remember the exact numbers now, but I think that page that I'm thinking of gets around 500 to 600 visitors per month from like only a couple weeks in publishing with 0 links. Now, one more bonus hack if you're interested in doing some influencer marketing and prospecting. So within Content Explorer, you can actually find influencers who might be interested in the content that you're creating. So if we search for link building, then you'll see that Content Explorer finds over 75,000 articles related to the topic. And this article looks interesting here. How long does it link building take to influence rankings? And since we have a ton of data here at Ahrefs and some of our own unique case studies like this one on how long it takes to rank in Google, basically the same topic, we could probably find some influencers who'd be interested in our research. You'll see that this post has just over 500 Twitter shares. And if we click on the Who Tweeted button, we can see all of the unique people who have shared this article on Twitter. From here, you can click any of the columns to sort by the tweet date, the total number of tweets on the account, the number of people they're following, the total number of followers they have, which might be interesting, or the total number of lists. I'm sure we could find some pretty influential people who'd be interested in some unique data and share the article with them. Now, if we go back to the search results page, you can actually select a few of the articles from here too. So I'll just choose these ones here for demonstration purposes. And then if we scroll back to the top, we can click the Who Tweeted Selected Articles button to get an even bigger list of prospects that we could then reach out to. So I hope you found this SEO tutorial helpful and that you'll start using Content Explorer to find some solid guest blocking opportunities and to find those low competition keywords that no keyword research tool could ever find. Now give me a thumbs up if you liked this video and let me know in the comments which Content Explorer hack you're going to try. That's it for this SEO tutorial. Make sure to subscribe for more actionable videos like this one, and I'll see you soon. Bye.